Hello everyone. In my previous video, I have defined basis. So basis for any vector space V is a linearly independent subset of V that generates V. In this video, we will discuss some theorems relating basis. So let us start with replacement theorem. Let V be a vector space that is generated by a set G that contains exactly n vectors. And L be a subset, linearly independent subset of V that contains exactly m vectors. Then m is less than equal to n, and there exists a subset H of G containing exactly n minus m vectors such that L union H generates V. We prove this result by mathematical induction on m. The induction begins with m equal to 0. For in this case, if m is equal to 0, then cardinality L is equal to 0. So then L is an empty set, so L is equal to 5. So we take H is equal to G, which gives the desired result. Now, suppose the theorem is true for some integer m greater than equal to 0. We will prove this theorem now for m plus 1. So let L is equal to V1, V2, V till Vm plus 1. This L is a linearly independent subset of V containing m plus 1 vectors. Since we have seen that a subset of linearly independent set is linearly independent, we get this V1, V2, Vm is linearly independent. So we now apply induction hypothesis. So we get that m is less than equal to n, and there is a subset u1, u2 till un minus m of G such that v1 to vm union this u1 to un minus m generates V. I have underlined this in red line. So now, since it generates V, vm plus 1 will be a linear combination of this element, these elements. So there exists some scalars a1 to am and b1 to bn minus m such that vm plus 1 can be expressed as a linear combination of these vectors, which is marked by equation number 9. Now we claim that this n minus m is greater than 0, because if it is not greater than 0, then it is equal to 0. So vm plus 1 will be expressed as a1 v1 plus a2 v2 till am vm. All these terms, since n minus m is 0, the terms involving b1 will be bi's will be 0. Vm plus 1 will be in span of v1 to vm. That is, v1 to vm plus 1 is linearly dependent. But you are already given that L is linearly independent. So this n minus m must be greater than 0. Since it is n minus m is greater than 0, we have n is greater than m. So n is greater than equal to m plus 1. Also, if we say some bi's, say b1 is non-zero, then we will get the same contradiction. So we have this b1 is non-zero, we can express u1 as this expression minus b1 inverse a1 times u1 and so on. We are multiplying this by b1 inverse and taking everything to right hand side except u1. Now H is equal to u1 u2 till un minus m, and by this equation u1 belongs to span of L union H, and because v1 v2 vm and u2 u3 till un minus m are in span of L union H, since they are contained in L union H, we get this set v1 v2 vm u1 u2 un minus n un minus m is contained in L union H. Now, since we are already given that v1 v2 till vm and u1 u2 till un minus m generates V, we get that span of L union H is equal to V. Since H is a subset of G that contains n minus m minus 1 elements, in H we have excluded u1. So n minus m minus 1 is equal to n minus m plus 1. Therefore, this theorem holds for m plus 1, and thus we complete the induction. Now, let's see this corollary. let V be a vector space having a finite basis. Then every basis for V contains the same number of elements. Suppose beta is a finite basis for V that contains exactly n vectors. And let gamma be another basis for V. We have to show number of elements in beta and gamma are same. If gamma contains more than n vectors, then we can select a subset S of gamma containing exactly n plus 1 vectors. Since S is a linearly independent set, because S is a subset of gamma and gamma is a basis, so gamma is linearly independent. Any subset of linearly independent is linearly independent, so S is linearly independent. And we know that beta generates V. So by previous theorem, we get n plus 1 is less than equal to n, which is a contradiction. Therefore, this gamma is finite and contains, and the number m of vectors in gamma satisfies m is less than equal to n. Now, reversing the roles of beta and gamma, proceeding as above, we get n is less than equal to m. Therefore, we get m is equal to n. Now, since for any vector space, we have shown that any basis will contain the same number of vectors. This same number will be called dimension. So let us see the definition. A vector space V is called finite dimensional if it has a basis consisting of finite number of vectors. The unique number of vectors in each basis for V is called dimension of V, and it is denoted by dim, dime of V. A vector space that is not finite dimensional is called infinite dimensional. Let us see some examples. If you have a trivial vector space, that is zero vector space, which is equal to singleton 0, then we know that phi was the basis. So span of phi was singleton 0 and phi is linearly independent. So this vector space singleton 0 has dimension 0. Now for this Fn, which is repeated n copies of F, e1, e2 till en were the basis for Fn. So dimension of this Fn is n. Similarly, in vector space of matrices of order m cross n over F, all eijs were basis where 1 was at the ijth position. So this vector space has dimension mn. In next example, Pnf, which have all polynomials of degree at most n. This set 1x, x square till xn was the basis. So the dimension is n plus 1. Number of elements in basis is the dimension. Now, next we see that the dimension of vector space depends on its field of scalars. If you have field of complex numbers and the vector space is also of complex numbers, then a basis can be expressed as 1. We get the dimension will be 1. But if you have field of real numbers, the vector space of complex numbers has basis 1i. So any element can be expressed in terms of 1 and iota. So this has dimension 2. Next corollary, let V be a vector space with dimension n. Any finite generated set for V contains at least n vectors, and a generating set for V that contains exactly n vectors is a basis. Next, any linearly independent subset of V that contains exactly n vectors is a basis. And last point, that every linearly independent subset of V can be extended to a basis for V. So for a basis, we have to show two things, that it is linearly independent and it generates V. But by this corollary, you can see that if you know the dimension of vector space, and if that set, suppose S is the subset of V that contains n elements, then if you prove it is linearly independent, then it is a basis, or if you prove it is a generating set, then it will be a basis. So basically, if it contains exactly same number of elements as the dimension of vector space, then you have to show just one thing, either generating or linearly independent, and it will turn out to be a basis. Let us start with the proof. Let beta be a basis for V. Let G be a finite generating set for V. Then a finite spanning set for V can be reduced to a basis. So we get some subset H of G, which is a basis for V. Now by previous corollary, H contains exactly n vectors. Since a subset of G contains n vectors, G must contain at least n vectors. Therefore, we must have H is equal to G. Since G contains exactly n vectors, therefore G is a basis for V. Second part, let L be a linearly independent subset of V containing exactly n vectors. Now from replacement theorem, there is a subset H of beta basis which contains n minus n equal to 0 vectors such that L union H generates V. Thus H is equal to phi since cardinality of H is 0 and L union H is equal to L, so L generates V. Since this L is also linearly independent, this L is a basis for V. Third part, if L is a linearly independent subset of V containing m vectors, then by replacement theorem, there is a subset H of beta containing n minus m vectors such that L union H generates V. From the first part of this theorem, we get that L union H contains exactly n vectors and thus L union H is a basis for V. Let us see this example. You are given a set x square plus 3x minus 2, 2x square plus 5x minus 3. Minus x square minus 4x plus 4. You have to show that this set is a basis for P2R. The standard basis for P2R is 1x, x square. So dimension is 3. These are 3 vectors of this set. So you have to show either spanning or linearly independence. We show that any arbitrary element of P2R, which is of the form ax square plus bx plus c, can be expressed in terms of these polynomials. So these 3 vectors span the entire set P2R. So we get this set forms a basis for P2R. Next example, we have to show these 4 vectors is a basis for M2 cross 2 over R. Now the standard basis for M2 cross 2 over R is 1 0 0 0, which I have mentioned here. So dimension is equal to 4. We are showing that any arbitrary element which is of the form a11, a12, a21, a22 can be expressed in terms of these 4 vectors. So these 4 vectors are spanning the entire space M2 cross 2 over R. Thus this set forms a basis over R. Next example we have to show that this set is a basis for R4. Now dimension of R4 is 4. The standard basis for R4 is E1, E2, E3, A4, where one is at the ith position. We are showing that this is a linearly independent set. Since all these vectors are linearly independent, this set forms a basis for R4. Next example, you are defining PKX as x to the power k plus 1 till xn. Now this subset P0x, P1x till PNx forms a basis for PNf. Standard basis for PNf is 1x, x square till x to the power n. So dimension was n plus 1. These are also n plus 1 vectors. We will show that these are linearly independent. I have already shown in previous videos of linearly dependence and independence that this will come out to be linearly independent. So this will form a basis for PNF. Let us see this theorem. Let W be a subspace of a finite dimensional vector space V. Then W is finite dimensional and dimension of W is less than equal to dimension of V. Moreover, if dimension W is equal to dimension V, then V is equal to W. That is, dimension of a subspace is always less than equal to dimension of the complete space. So let dimension V is equal to N. If W is equal to singleton 0, then W is finite dimensional and dimension W is equal to 0, which is always less than equal to n. Otherwise, W contains a non-zero vector x1. So singleton x1 is linearly independent set. Now continue choosing vectors x2, x3 till xk in W such that the set x1, x2 till xk is linearly independent. Since no linearly independent subset of V can contain more than n vectors because dimension of V was n. So maximum linearly independent vectors can be n. This process must stop at some stage k which is less than equal to n. So x1 to xk is linearly independent. And if we add any other vector from W, this will give you a linearly dependent set. Now we claim that this x1, x2, xk generates W. That is, span of x1, x2, xk is equal to W. So let W belongs to W. If W is some xi, then clearly we have this W belongs to span of this x1, x2, xk. If W is not equal to xi, then this W union x1, x2, xk will give you a linearly dependent set. We have constructed x1 to xk in such a way that if we add any other vector from W, it will give you a linearly dependent set. That is, W belongs to span of x1, x2 till xk. Therefore, we get W is contained in span of, here it should be W, W is contained in span of x1 to xk. Therefore, W is equal to span of x1 to xk. So, dimension of W is equal to k, which is less than equal to n. Now, if dimension W is equal to n, then a basis for W is linearly independent subset of V containing n vectors. By second corollary, we get that this basis for W is also a basis for V. So we get that W is equal to V. Let us see this example. We are given a set W. Then we have to show that dimension of W is equal to 3. So we have to show that this set forms a basis for W. So consider any arbitrary element of W which have these two properties, a1 plus a3 plus a5 is equal to 0 and a2 is equal to a4. So we are showing that W is equal to span of this three vectors, and we will show that these three vectors are linearly independent. So we consider c1 times first vector, c2 times second vector plus c3 times third vector equal to 0 vector. We show that all these coefficient ci's are 0. So this is a linearly independent set. This forms a basis for W. Next example. The set of diagonal n cross n matrices in a subspace W of m n cross n over F. Then this basis e11, e22, that is all 1s are at the diagonal position. In e11, 1 is at the first position, rest is 0. In e22, 1 is at the a22 position, second row, second column position, rest are equal to 0. Thus we show that dimension of W is equal to n. You can look at this proof. You have to show spanning and linearly independence part. Next corollary, if W is a subspace of finite dimensional vector space V, then any basis for W can be extended to a basis for V. So let S be a set, S be a basis for W, then S is linearly independent subset of V. By corollary 2, we have that this S can be extended to a basis for V. So any basis for W can be extended to a basis for V. Last example, if you have a set of all polynomials of this form, it have all even powers, a18, x18 plus a16, x to the power 16, so on. This is a subspace W of P18F. Basis for W will be 1, x square, x16, x18, which is a subset of standard basis for P18 over F. Thank you for watching this video.